Okay, now we've got the second passage, and we're going to start off with that. And the title of the second passage is Driverless Cars. And you know, second passage is labeled. So labeled passage means it will be type B question. Driverless cars. So you know what a driverless car is, a car without a driver. And it's just because of artificial intelligence, they have these cars. Okay, now if you come to questions 14 to 18, reading passage 2 has 7 sections. Which section contains the following information? We call it which paragraph contains the following information. There are 5 questions, and for these 5 questions, you need 5 rounds of all the passage. So these 5 questions can eat all your time. And they can confuse you if you're not familiar with the passage. So I advise you to do them last. Yes, the best thing you can do, you can read the questions first so that you have some idea. As you are answering other questions, if any answer comes in your way, you can just pick that and write it. Otherwise, you can go on. Next, questions 19 to 22, we have summary completion. And questions 23 to 26, double multiple choice. So where should we start from? Summary completion first, then you can do double multiple choice, because double multiple choice is also type A. Questions and answers are in order. And finally, you can do this, which paragraph contains the following information. So choose no more than 2 words. I'm solving questions 19 to 22. Impact of driverless cars. Figures from Transport Research Laboratory. You can see TRL, they are capital. Now go back and look for Transport Research Laboratory. Transport Research Laboratory. Okay. Second page, first paragraph, Transport Research Institute. No, we are looking for laboratory. Paragraph B, second line, UK's Transport Research Laboratory. Found it? Now this is the location. And answers will start from here, and you need to read on, and you will find all the answers. Now we read the question. Transport Research Laboratory indicates that most motor accidents are partly due to dash. Most road accidents are partly due to dash. So I'm reading paragraph B, second line. Research at the UK's Transport Research Laboratory has demonstrated that 90% means most, road accidents involve means due to human error. What is the answer? Human error. Well done. Okay, 90% of road collisions involve human error. So what is the question? Motor accidents are partly due to, okay? So most motor accidents, for that they use 90%. And for involve, they use due to. And human error will be the right answer. Okay, so the introduction of driverless vehicles will result in greater safety in addition to the direct benefits of automation. Question number 20. It may bring other advantages. For example, schemes for, underline the word scheme. And commonly for scheme, they use the word scheme, plan, initiative. Like, you know, they use the word government's initiative for corruption, government initiative for something. So scheme, plan, initiative, and all that. For example, schemes for dash will be more workable, especially in towns and cities. Now we go back. Schemes for what will be more workable? Please come to paragraph C. Paragraph C, third line, after full stop. At present, found it? At present, the average car spends more than 90% of its life parked. Automation means the initiatives for car sharing. Initiative. Initiative means scheme. Scheme for car sharing. Initiative for car sharing become much more viable, particularly in urban areas and all that. So, car sharing will be the answer, and initiative means scheme. Now, if you know these words, you can find your answer without any delay. And if you don't know, you'll be looking here and there, and eventually you will write a wrong answer. Okay, next we've got, according to the University of Michigan Transportation Research, look for University of Michigan. Come on, scan, University of Michigan. Second page, first paragraph, modeling work by the University of Michigan Transportation. So this is the location for the answer. Now we read. So they say here, there could be a 43% drop in dash of cars. Now 43% drop in dash of cars. Please come back. Can you see 43%? Okay, so I'm reading it from second line. Michigan Transportation Research Institute suggests automated vehicles might reduce vehicle ownership by 43%. So what is dropping 43%? Vehicle ownership. And we are supposed to write one word. Okay. But listen, when they say vehicle ownership, what does vehicle mean? Car. So you cannot say vehicle ownership of cars. Answer is only ownership. Yes, ownership will be the right answer. Why not vehicle? Because they have already mentioned of cars. Of cars, cars is another word for vehicle. So correct answer is ownership. Okay, however, this would mean that the yearly dash, now underline the word yearly. For yearly, they use the word yearly, annually, or any other word throughout the year of each car. Yearly dash of each car. Come back to same paragraph after ownership. But that vehicle's average annual mileage. What is the answer? Mileage. Annual mileage. Annual mileage means yearly mileage. So correct answer is mileage. Be careful with the spelling. M-I-L-E, mile. And then another word is age. Mileage is the right answer. Okay? All right, now after this, we come to questions 23-24. Which two benefits, questions 23-24, which two benefits of automated vehicles does the writer mention? Now, we need to find a paragraph where they talk about benefit. And usually these answers are in one paragraph, mostly. Sometimes one paragraph and the second paragraph as well. So, which two benefits of automated vehicles does the writer mention? Please come to the passage. And you can see paragraph B, second part of paragraph B. Another aim is to free. Now, this is the benefit. They are talking about benefit. Got it? Section B, second paragraph. Another aim is. Now, let's read from here. Found this paragraph? Okay. Another aim is to free the time people spend driving for other purposes. If the vehicle can do some or all the driving, it may be possible to be productive. Now, these are benefits. Underline that. First benefit is you can be productive. To socialize means you can use social media. You can call someone. Hello, yeah, I am in automated car, driverless car. How are you? And you can talk to someone. But you will say we can talk while driving, okay? Or simply to relax. Third benefit is you can relax. Let's go on. While automation system have responsibility for the safe control of the vehicle, if the vehicle can do the driving, those who are challenged by existing mobility model, such as older or disabled travelers, another benefit, disabled travelers and older people, they can also go anywhere if there is a driverless car. Now, these are the benefits may be able to enjoy significantly. Now, you will keep these benefits in mind and you will go down the list of five options, eliminating the wrong options, and you will find the right answer. Option A, car travelers could enjoy considerable cost saving. Did they mention any cost saving? Not at all. Now, four options are left. Option B, it would be easier to find parking spaces in urban areas. They did not mention parking. So success rate is more. Out of three, two are right options. Option C, travelers could spend journeys doing something other than driving, socialize, relax, be productive. Okay, so C is the first right answer. Option D, people who find driving physically difficult could travel independently. That's true. Disabled people or older people who find driving difficult. So D is the second right answer. Option E, reduction in the number of cars would mean reduction in pollution. They did not mention. Okay, so eliminating the wrong answer will take you to the right answer. Option C and option D, they are the right answers. Now we go on questions 25 and 26. Which two challenges, difficulties, problems, issues, and all that. Which two challenges to automated vehicle development does the writer mention? Now, two difficulties in the way to automated vehicle development. Now, we are going to see challenges, difficulties, and all that. Hurdles. Scan a paragraph where they talk about hurdles. Well done. Paragraph F. Now, both answers are going to be here, okay? So, you're solving two questions, and when you're solving two questions, if it takes more than a minute, or if it takes a little more time, that's normal, because you're solving two questions, okay? You got to keep that in mind. Now, there are a number of hurdles to overcome in delivering automated vehicles to our roads. These means hurdles. All right. These include technical difficulties in ensuring that the vehicle works reliably in the infinite range of traffic. Underline infinite range of traffic. Weather and road situation. So traffic, weather, and road situation. So car is working well. It might encounter the regulatory challenges. Regulatory means law. I mean, there are traffic laws as well, regulatory challenges, and in understanding how liability and enforcement might change. So, there are traffic challans also and all that. So, it has to see all that. When drivers are no longer essential for vehicle operation and the societal changes that may be required, underline societal changes, for communities to trust and accept automated vehicles as being a valuable part of the mobility landscape. I was watching a vlog. There was somebody in Dubai sitting in a driverless car, and that lady was saying, I'm so scared. I don't know if the car is going to bump into someone or it's going to cause an accident. What will happen? So this is what we say, societal changes. If you are told that you're going to sit in a pilotless aeroplane, there is no pilot and it's going to fly on its own, you'll be thinking 10 times that there may be a crash or anything like that, okay? So we need societal changes, regulatory, these are the issues, weather, traffic, and all that. We keep all these things in mind, and now we come to the options. Option A, making sure general public has confidence in automated vehicles. That is societal changes, right? So this is mentioned here. They say societal changes that may be required for communities to trust. Trust means confidence. And very commonly for trust, they use the word confidence. So first correct answer is A. Option B, managing pace of transition from conventional to automated vehicles. Did they talk about pace of transition? No, speed of transition. Pace means speed. Option C, deciding how to compensate professional drivers who become redundant. Redundant means jobless. Did they talk about jobless drivers and how to compensate and all that? Option D, setting up infrastructure to make roads suitable for automated vehicles. They did not say that we will change the roads altogether and the roads will suit automated vehicles. Automated vehicles should follow the traffic rules, the weather, and all that. So it is not mentioned. Option E, getting automated vehicles to adapt to various different driving conditions. Now, what are driving conditions? Bad weather, traffic regulations, then there is the traffic jams, right? So these are different driving conditions, and correct answer is E. So the right answers are option A and option E. Okay, now after this, finally, we go to this question type 14 to 18. Which section contains the following information? We are going to do that. Question number 14. Now, I'll tell you how to read the question. And from the question, you need to find what type of information you're going to scan. For this question type, you need scanning. If you start reading, you cannot read the whole passage. So you will scan using your pencil and you will have in mind specific piece of information. So, question number 14, reference to amount of time when car is not in use. Look here. When car is not in use means car is parked. Amount of time means if they say 50% car spend its time in parking. Or 60% car spends its life in the parking and all that. Now look for parking, time, percentage and all that. Start scanning from paragraph A. All right, paragraph C, third line, at present. Found it? Paragraph C, third line. At present, the average car spends more than 90% of its life parked. Now, this is one sentence only. So, from the whole passage, you need to find a sentence like that. Right? Average car spends more than 90% of its life parked. Reference to amount of time. More than 90% is amount of time. A car is not in use. Not in use means car is parked. So question number 14, answer is C. Question number 15, mention of several advantages of driverless vehicles. You know it already. See that? That's why we do it in the end. That is paragraph B, where they talk about you may socialize. Okay, relax, right? That is paragraph, that is section B. Actually, you know, section B contains two paragraphs. Section A contains two paragraphs. So they use the word section. Okay, so correct answer is section B, second paragraph, and there they talk about all these benefits. So for question number 15, correct answer is B. All right, question number 16, reference to the opportunity of choosing most appropriate vehicle for each trip. Now look here, reference to the opportunity of choosing most appropriate vehicle. They may talk about some vehicles like small car, big wagon, right? Small family, 5 people car, 10 people wagon and all that. So scan something like that. Well done. That is section E. Section E, first paragraph, third line. Drivers will have the freedom to select one. And then in the previous line, they say automation may, I'm reading it from the beginning, paragraph E. Automation may prompt other changes in vehicle manufacture. If we move to a model where consumers are tending not to own a single vehicle, but to purchase access to a range of vehicles. Now, for range of vehicles, they use the word most appropriate vehicle for each trip. And we read on range of vehicles through a mobility provider. Drivers will have the freedom to select one. So you will have the freedom to select one car, like you need a small car, you are going alone, you need a family car and all that. So question number 16, reference to the opportunity of choosing most appropriate vehicle for each trip. That is that. Question number 17, estimate of how long it will take to overcome a number of problems. You know the problem paragraph. Now you're going to see how long will it take to overcome these problems. Well done. That is paragraph G, exactly. It is clear that there are many challenges that need to be addressed, but through robust and targeted research, these can probably be conquered within the next 10 years. Okay, so correct answer is paragraph G for question number 17. They said 10 years, okay. Now, let's go on. Question number 18, suggestion that the use of driverless cars may have no effect on the number of vehicles manufactured. Now look for number of vehicles manufactured, driverless cars, no effect on that. Okay, paragraph E. Okay, so correct answer is paragraph D for doctor. Yeah, paragraph D, we are reading it from the beginning. Yeah, it's the second paragraph of D. Second paragraph of D, and we have read it already. Modeling work, found it? Yeah. So, modeling work by the University of Michigan Transportation Research Institute suggested automated vehicles might reduce vehicle ownership by 43%, but that vehicles' average annual mileage would double as a result. As a consequence, each vehicle would be used more intensively and might need replacing sooner. This faster rate of turnover may mean that vehicle production will not necessarily decrease. Okay, now come back. A suggestion that the use of driverless cars may have no effect on the number of vehicles manufactured. For that, they said vehicle production will not necessarily decrease. So that is section D. Correct answer for question number 18 is D. Got it? All right.